Welcome. In this session, we'll be looking into what we'll be calling as black box optimization problem, right? So this we had already discussed, but here we thought we would just demonstrate it to you so that it stays back in our memory, right? So black box optimization problems, we are defining it as optimization problems where we do not know what is happening inside the problem, right? So the problem is a black box. The only things that we know about the optimization problem is we know how many decision variables are there, what are the lower bounds and what are the upper bounds, right? And we have a mechanism wherein if we give a set of decision variables, that mechanism which we do not know, right? So it may be an experiment or it may be a person who is taking the values of the decision variable, but is able to give back the objective function value or the fitness function value, right? So we do not exactly know how that is being calculated, but we have this black box mechanism wherein given a set of decision variables, we are able to get the fitness function value. So what we are discussing is true for all the five algorithms which we have discussed so far. So we will just demonstrate it on TLBO and it holds for all the other four algorithms. Before actually looking into it, let's quickly revise the pseudocode of teaching learning based optimization, right? So in teaching learning based optimization, we have a fitness function, right? Again, this is what has become now black box, right? So previously we knew that given x1, x2, x3, x4, right? The fitness function is x1 square plus x2 square plus x3 square plus x4 square. So this is the problem that we had worked, right? So right now what we are going to do is that we do not know how this f is calculated, but there is a mechanism to which if we give x, it will return back f, right? So this is the black box optimization problem that we are talking about, right? We need to know the lower bound and upper bound. Once we know the lower bounds and upper bounds, we can obviously calculate how many decision variables are there. And now we need to also specify the population size and the number of iterations that we need to perform, right? So the first step is to initialize a random population and evaluate its fitness. So for evaluating its fitness, we have a mechanism which will give us the fitness. We do not know what is happening inside this black box optimization. Then we need to perform the t iterations, right? For t equal to 1 to t. So that is, this is the iteration loop. And for each iteration, each member is supposed to undergo the teacher phase as well as the learner phase, right? So for I is equal to 1 to np, we select the best solution, we determine the mean of the population, we generate a new solution. This new solution is not guaranteed to be in the bounds, so we employ a corner bounding strategy and evaluates its fitness function. So again here we'll be making use of this black box optimization problem. We'll be accepting the new solution if it is better, else we'll be discarding the new solution. So the first member undergoes the teacher phase, so this is the teacher phase, and then it undergoes the learner phase. So for learner phase, we need to randomly select a member xp. So this xp should not be the same as the ith member which is undergoing the population, and we need to determine the new solution using one of this equation, right? One of this equation gets selected depending upon the fitness of the ith solution and the pth partner which has been selected, right? So once we generate a new solution from here, we again need to bound, because this does not ensure that the new solution would be bounded. We need to bound and we need to evaluate the fitness function, right? So again, when we want to evaluate the fitness function, we'll have to make use of this black box procedure, right? And we'll be accepting the new solution if it is better than the ith member which is undergoing the learner phase, right? This has to be performed for all the np members, and this iteration has to be performed t times. So this is the pseudocode of TLBO, right? So now let's look into this, right? So here we have the TLBO code which we have previously discussed, right? So we'll not get into this because this we have already discussed, right? So here we have a problem, right? The problem is BBOP. The name of the file is BBOP. So let us look at what are the files which are there in the current folder. So in the current folder we have three files. This TLBO is the TLBO function which you can see over here. This script is this file, right? So this is a script file for black box optimization using TLBO, right? So this file, so both of these are M files. So here if you see, it's given MATLAB code files, right? So MATLAB code files, we can open it over here and we can actually see what is happening inside, right? And we have this one P file named BBOP, right? So that is our fitness function. So we do not know what is happening inside this BBOP. We cannot even look into it, Right now we have this black box in terms of an P code. So P code, if you want to look at the help of P code, you can do help P code. So P code create content obscured executable files. Once a P code is generated, right? So a P code can be generated from a M file. Right. Once a P code has been generated, if someone gets the P code, right, they will not be able to see what is inside it, but they can use it. So it's more like an executable file. So if we can create P code just by giving P code and name of whatever file we want to convert into P code. So for example, this TLBO, if we want to convert this TLBO into a P code, we just need to give P code. TLBO. If we give this P code TLBO, it will convert it into a P code. So here if we give what, now if I remove this TLBO, right, from this script, from this folder, right, so let's say open, let's cancel this, let me just close it first. So if I delete this, right, now if we see what, it has one script file, it has two P code file, one is the algorithm and another one is the problem. So here we showed you how to convert a file into P code, right? So now TLBO, I can continue to use it, but I will not be able to see what is happening inside TLBO. So for example, over here, if you see, you don't even get to see the P code files. This browser shows only the M files. Right? So if we go to this folder, and even if you try to open it with a notepad, so these two both are P coded file. So if I try to open it even with a notepad file, I will not be able to see what exactly is happening into it. Right, so this is all that you can see. So what we are trying to emphasize is, let's say someone gives you an optimization problem, but is not willing to say what is the optimization problem, but is only willing to tell you the lower bound and the upper bound. So even then, you can use one of these five metaheuristic technique to solve the optimization problem for them, right? So here currently, we have this BBOP is the optimization problem that we are solving. We converted into P code so that you can understand how to create P code and what are P files. Now the optimization problem BBOP is a black box for us. We do not know what is happening inside that, but we know the lower bound and the upper bound, right? So we can still use TLBO. So we are calling the function TLBO, and we know that the first argument has to be a function handle, right, which contains the problem statement, the lower bound, the upper bound, the population size, and the number of iterations. So this is the input, right? And TLBO function, if you remember, or you can even download and see it, the output from TLBO function which we had written was the best solution, the best fitness. So at the end of the procedure, what is the best solution that we have encountered, what is its fitness function value, and this is the best fitness in every iteration. So since here we are performing 100 iterations, right? So what is the best value at the end of every iteration that is stored in this best fit iter? This P is the population at the end of last iteration, and this F is the fitness function corresponding to this population P. Right? So now if you understand this discussion, you would be able to appreciate that we do not know anything about BBOP, what is happening inside BBOP. Right? Still, if we run this code, you will be able to see that we will be able to optimize that problem. Right? So that problem has 54 decision variables. The lower bound for all the 54 decision variables is 0. The upper bound is as given over here. The best solution has a fitness function of minus 520.75. If we see this best fit iter, right? So we had performed 100 iterations, right? So best fit iter will have 101 values because of the initial population also, right? So let me put it in a better format to see all the values. So now if we see the initial population, the best member had a fitness of this, right? And subsequently it got decreased, right? So as the algorithm progressed, we were able to get increasingly better solutions, right? So from these very large values, we came to minus 306, 374, 412, 449, minus 449, minus 471, and minus 516, minus 520. Right. So, at the end of 100 iterations with a population size of 100, the best solution that we could find was minus 520.75. Again, we have run this only for one time. This we can again do the statistical analysis which we have discussed previously. So, for example, here we can say for I is equal to 1 to n runs end over here. So, here if we define number of runs is equal to 5, let us say we want to implement 5 runs, right. So, all these variables can be initialized, right. So, right now we are initializing with NaN, right. So, right now we need to change the random number every time, right. So, the seed we are going to change, all this we have discussed previously. If you do not remember, you will have to look into the statistical analysis video, right. So, over here every time we are executing with a different random seed. So, this doing multiple runs we have seen previously, right. If you are not able to recollect, you can go back and have a look at the video. So, what we are trying to show you over here is that I do not necessarily need to know what is happening inside the optimization problem, right. Even if I do not know, I can still use this metaheuristic techniques, right. So, right now we have executed this whatever this optimization problem in BBOP is. Remember, we did not even look at what is BBOP, right. The file itself was not, we were not able to open, right. It had this mechanism that if we give the set of decision variables, it will return us the fitness function value, right. So, now we can have a look at the best fitness, right. So, in the 5 runs, this is the best fitness we were able to obtain, right. So, we can also have a look at this best fit iter. So, let me just transpose it, right. So, each column now indicates one run, right, and the number of values in best fit iter would be 101, right. So, if we do whose of this, so best fit iter, it is 5 × 101, right. So, each of this we can plot. So, each of this is a convergence curve for the 5 runs and mean at every iteration and have a single convergence curve. Right. So, all statistical analysis can be performed. So, here we have shown you how to solve a black box optimization problem using teaching learning based optimization, right. The exactly same thing works for all the other 4 techniques which we have discussed. So, that is one of the best things about metaheuristic techniques is that even if we do not have knowledge about what is the optimization problem, right, we only know what are the lower bounds, what are the upper bounds, and from that we know how many decision variables are there, right. In addition to that, if we have some mechanism, right, we need not know what is the mechanism, but we have some mechanism which can be used so that we can get the fitness function value, right. So, over here the optimization problem can even be an experiment, right. You get a set of decision variables, go and perform an experiment, find out what is the fitness function and feed it back into the metaheuristic technique, right, or it can be other simulations also. So, for example, for every set of decision variables, you may have to run some other software. Let us say you have to run Fluent or even a Simulink model, which takes time to execute, and once it gets executed, you get a fitness function value from it, right. So, even in those cases, this metaheuristic techniques can be easily used, right. That concludes this session on black box optimization problems. Thank you.